This is Lurch from C-Die Lurch, back with Stories, the Paths of Destinies. As you might remember, last time we did finish a story, which was, it was stupid. I try not to get too down on these guys, because the graphics and everything, and obviously they spent a lot of time, but... I mean, okay, look at now. I finished this story. Never fought a boss fight. Apparently got killed at the end by this cat. And never had the chance to do it, which, you know, is asinine. Because it's a game. So I think, you know, there's one of our truths. That Zenobia has feelings for Renardo. Okay, that's fine, but I also learned there's one overall truth, and that's that this is more of a book than a game. And that's kind of sad. I mean, now I'm seeing that we got four truths over here, and, you know, one is probably, you know, I don't know, Renardo sucks, you know, it's probably Renardo, you know, he fell down the stairs a lot when he was a kid, or he probably, I mean, Renardo eats boogers, I don't know, I mean, there's gonna be something stupid, I know, and I'm gonna find out, I guess we'd be lucky if that was all of it, but, well, okay, let's see what other kind of crap they throw me into.
The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base.
Oh, no.
They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky River
game changers. Isn't those guys or in, like, EA Sports in the mountains that are really good at the games? They
surely the
like
weapon
posts.
That banished the lost gods could defeat the Emperor.
Also, Sky Ripper.
A temple had risen
Sky
out of
Ripper.
Empty desert.
Temple.
The Emperor had brought the Sky Ripper pieces up out of ancient burial by his obscene rituals.
His obscene rituals.
Could this be what the Ibris Stone was
I'm just kind of curious as to what those
does,
are. Is this like...
Thought Renardo.
You know,
on the other hand,
is it like
his old friend
sitting
Lupino
in the bathroom,
needed
like... You know,
Lupino was no game
tubes
changer,
up his ass or something,
could
and,
Renardo
and, you know,
really leave an old friend to the Ravens?
Say it backwards over and over, like, you know, Renardo is a, oh, you know, so I already, wait, okay. Okay, so did I, that's the one I already did, right, is that why it's, I don't know, okay. We've already done that and I didn't, Okay, so I guess we'll do this one then, right? Or I kind of want to find the temple. Yeah, I guess we'll do them in order.
Every child knew about the Sky Ripper.
Yeah,
the transcendent
kids, yeah,
emperor
they all knew about
its
it.
Pieces.
They're all like,
what could have brought them to life?
Yeah, you know, we're gonna,
this
do,
emperor,
we're gonna get older. We're gonna,
the
we're
third,
gonna find
once
these.
Kind,
we're gonna find the Sky Ripper.
Mad.
We're gonna make it into
and
a
now
bomb.
He was conducting secret, obscene rituals to bring back the lost
take
gods.
Back to
and
Keller's
he
garage.
Summoned the long-lost components of the legendary weapon out of the deep places of the earth.
And 3 days later,
was more than
Renardo
could fathom.
Somebody else's
but if he could find a legendary weapon, he would use it.
He's gonna use it. He's gonna use it. Oh. Back to this, huh? Back to the, whatever this is. I just found it odd. You know, that there are, you know, straight from, Disney's
as he set foot in the aisle, Renardo could not help but feel a tinge of guilt. He'd left Lupino behind.
Oh, fuck.
He hoped
fuck
the mad
Lupino.
Rabbit had somehow escaped the ravens. He hoped they hadn't eaten him. If they had, he hoped they hadn't eaten him alive.
Maybe.
Why had he chosen the Sky Ripper?
Well, because
Renardo
I
never
did the other way, and I know what happened.
Constant vigilance. He was a hero. He didn't think too much. He just went with his gut and hoped it all worked out. The Sky
no,
Ripper was
didn't.
A long
the
shot.
Only thing they left was
he'd
the,
have to devote himself to
lack
no
of
side
a bad
journeys,
Latin
no
accent,
rescuing
like
old
the,
friends.
Don Carnage
that was
of,
against his nature.
Tailspin.
Could he stick with it?
Of course we're gonna stick with it. I'm pretty sure this game isn't gonna let me do anything but. It's. It kind of reminds me of, like, I mean, there is a parallel between, you know, between the Choose Your Own Adventure books and a lot of video games. I mean, especially RPGs, like really good RPGs that aren't linear. You know, not the whole walking, you know, running down a big hallway of some of the more recent RPGs, like Final Fantasy 13. It was really bad like that, but It's just that you have to give them their own choice. I mean, let me make my own decisions and have the, you know, the multiple endings are great. They are. I love that kind of shit. But I'm really glad they didn't make me get a ton of collectibles. It's, wait, can I make that? I still don't know what I'm doing. No, guess not. Yeah. So, no, I can play with my gem slot now. Ooh. Oh, I can, but I don't have any, so. Well, whatever. You really don't need them. I mean, it just forces you to make these stupid swords. I like that. I like this design, though, in these worlds. This is awesome. If I could change the camera angle, I'd give it like an A+, man. That's awesome. It's very, very... Oh, I've been in here before, haven't I? These damn things. It's really nice of them to, like, light up where they're gonna go. I mean, that's... You know, helps a lot.
Anyone ever tell you you have a lovely eye? No?
What the hell are you talking about? A lovely eye, huh? Looks like watermelon. I see that the difficulty doesn't really increase very much, at least. Ooh, a lever!
Oh.
Didn't say anything. Oh.
Give me a lever, said Archimedes, and I shall open a gate.
No, and you're an asshole for saying that. We gotta drag Archimedes into this. I mean, what the hell did he do? He do anything to you? You bastard. I know I can charge the sword up, but I don't know why I want to. These things die in one hit. There we go. This isn't exactly Ninja Gaiden, or, well. There you go, well.
The people who had built this castle, did they even know what monstrous weapon lay hidden within their walls? The sky
well,
could
destroy
anything
it
touched.
Or
so the legend said.
They built it.
As the Transcendent Emperor had fought the Lost Gods, thousands of thousands had died. But Renardo had been through wars. The only merciful war was a short one.
And the best narrator is a silent one.
Every day he was getting better and better.
Through three truths. Like, do I have to? Don't do it. Don't make a comment. Don't do it. Come on, good there you go. Good narrator, good narrator. Just stay quiet, please. Yeah. Smart-ass remark from this goofball. Wrong, so I don't boy. I'm just waiting. Now that I'm just waiting, I just keep waiting for it to abruptly end and tell me that the story's over or something, and that I got killed by, a cartoon cat with a gigantic forehead. Hating on the Ravens, too. Like, I mean, I know they're a shitty football team, but... that's right. I forgot. Gotta do it to them. That's right.
Hey. Renardo has learned so much about... Ooh, what was it again?
Broken furniture. I love how they had, health upgrades inside of the furniture. Like, Nobody's ever gonna find it here. I'm gonna build this bench and I'm gonna put some food in it. And I'm just gonna hope that nobody has to, you know, nobody breaks it open, because it's kind of my job, but I'm curious what's over here. Probably nothing I want. You know what I really hate? Mazes.
Ice walls only let you through if they knew you were cool.
Aw, you bastard. Really? You're gonna come up with a pun like that? Shrouded in a thick fog. The most believable tale is that a transcendent emperor has used the Sky Ripper to banish bliss. Oh. You don't like writing that out? We're gonna have to, We're gonna just use the initials TE from now on. Actually, I kind of don't blame you. I don't know why you call him the Transcendent Emperor. I mean, that's, Oh, it's a secret journal, but he hid it in the open behind, well, as long as they never go down this path, they'll never find it. You know, if they don't solve my simple maze. Now the treasure too, as long as they don't get past my, wooden path.
This chest was really awesome.
See what I did there?
Yeah, I see what you did there. You should get bitch slapped. Come on. It's awesome. I did you too. The worst is making a pun, but you know, it's unforgiven. Cannot be forgiven for referencing that pun. Haha. See what I did there? No, but I read it, asshole, and now I am now dumber for having read that. I love these flashlights that can only see just that little distance. So, as long as I stay here, he'll never see me. Oh, God. But at least in this game, as far as I know, there's no collectibles. I hate collectibles. Some of the best games that I've played have ruined themselves with these collectibles.
Find all 150 Riddler trophies.
No! How about you add something to your game? How about you, you know, make a gameplay change, have some sort of a hidden, hidden plot lines and yada. I mean...
Didn't your mother tell you
wouldn't that make sense?
Snapdrenado,
no, let's go make him find a bunch of trophies with some half-assed riddles. You know, every single person that's ever done it is just looking them up online. I got hit by one. Oh, God damn it, now there's more. God, these things suck. And then they disappear.
Gee, I wonder which way you're going. Oh no, you're gonna come towards me, isn't that nice?
Now die, asshole. I do kinda like the fact there doesn't seem to be a whole lot of level gaining, I guess, but... On the other hand, these guys really, I haven't run into too many that are actually, like, difficult. And of course, if they're just not gonna let you fight bosses, I guess you really don't need to level up, right? Nope, can't climb that tiny fence. Can't be doing that. 3-foot fences, you know.
Interrupted story time.
Call it the lead, Raven.
Now I'll never find out how it ended.
What the hell are you talking about? Is that how a raisin? A radiant raisin? It might as well be, I guess. Oh. Uh-oh. Oh, no. against the wall like an asshole. Well, I'm kind of screwed here.
Bye-bye life, he thought.
I wish he said bye-bye life. I mean, hello emptiness. As he's dead. You have died. Oh, no shit. Oh, this doesn't make me go way back. Some of the fights, and this isn't a lot of games, it's like, they just seem like, it just feels, you know, makes you feel removed when you're fighting somebody that's, you know, that far back. Yeah, you missed me, asshole. Not that time. Oh, I was running away from him like an asshole. I didn't think I'd get hit him. Alright, whatever. I'll pay attention. Shit happens. Oh man, look at this impossible maze.
Ah, a puzzle. Renata loved puzzles. Except when he couldn't figure them out.
Like this one.
On the other hand, if there was a puzzle, it was probably meant to keep people away from something good.
Or it was just, you know, somebody's an asshole. Puzzles are for people that love to be confused. Some things.
See? That wasn't so hard.
No, it wasn't. Look at that. Puzzles in video games can piss me off, too. They just, to me, a lot of times, they actually just distract from the gameplay or from the game environment. You're trying to, I gotta solve this puzzle of these gateways to get through here. Oh, that's one of those fucking things. That's pointless, huh? Good job. Not really paying attention. Who cares about that? No. There's health. No. Oh, yeah. Seems like one of those things that can turn out to be completely useless to me.
Hey, I wonder if I'll have to fight some ravens.
There it was.
Maybe not.
Skyripper's armature. The stuff that dreams are made of. Engineers' dreams, anyway. The device was intricate. No one alive had the skill to make a thing like it. How is it part of a weapon at all? He'd have to ask a scientist. First, he'd get the second piece. Skyripper had a heart, a core that had come to rest on the next island. Well, there was another island he could reach. Zenobia had just invaded it with her father's Raven battalions. She must be encamped there still. But fighting Zenobia now, that made no sense at all. He'd already sacrificed one friend to get this armature, was it? He didn't need to hurry to face her. Okay. She would find him.
So you're kind of guiding me to a decision here.
It was a no-brainer.
Yeah,
he'd sacrificed his old friend Lupino to get the armature. And the armature was useless by itself, only a series of coils and wheels. War demanded sacrifices, and he would make more before the end. He would have to choose the greatest good, no matter how much it cost him.
Zenobia,
he would see her sooner or later, across a battlefield or a sword's point before all this was over. He was sure of that. The power was in the core. Obviously, he had to get the core.
It kind of looks like one of those things.
Before he was even out of sight of the Farfarer.
Gyroscope.
Why had he chosen the Sky Ripper? It was the sort of path he'd always avoided. The path of responsibility, of seriousness. Had he grown up? He didn't feel grown up.
He'd
made this decision from his gut, like he always did. Somehow. He'd impulsively decided to stop being impulsive. Did that make any sense?
Mom, I've got hair on my balls. Finally.
Fucking treasure.
Renato had a lot of crafting materials. Now all he needed was a crafting bench.
So he's gonna build one in Minecraft. Follow the red brick road. I love these people leave crafting benches all over the place. Come over here to my random woods and forge yourself a sword. I'll just leave you a crafting bench here so you can die. Good idea. I think I'll jump down this glowing hole.
There was something sour in the air. Like the earth had ruptured over something that had been fermenting for a very long time.
Well, it was just a hot dog she had in her crash.
Time to take it out. I can smell you. Smell like the toilet. Time to take that hot dog out of here.
You couldn't see it.
Jeez, they make it so hard to get your frickin' health back. Look at that. Like the furthest I've gotten is half a bag. What the hell was that?
The way they could hurt you and you couldn't hurt them back.
Yeah! Can I just kill that thing now? Can that be nice? Apparently not. That's why I was looking around for health. I'll hit and shit, let's see. Take a quick run back here. So. Really doesn't restrict your views or your movement all that terribly. Still, yeah, kind of annoying those. Hate invisible walls. Sonic Adventure series is notorious for that. I don't remember how to kill those. That's what's killing me.
Touché, he said, and died.
No, he didn't, because I didn't say that.
There were fewer and fewer trees. There were only these huge crystalline growths.
Oh,
had those been here before?
I didn't realize that's part of the sky.
He no longer heard birds except for the feverish cawing of the ravens when they attacked. He couldn't smell the small animals of the forest, the mice and rabbits. Where are they gone? And he was getting hungry too. This was an unhealthy place to be.
Skill points, duh. I didn't even look up there. Stick the sword in this asshole. I could just climb over. It's only like 6 feet. Fucking step ladder.
wasn't making a dent in those shields.
That's why I threw a fucking gun. Some half-assed enemies out there and then put up a gate that automatically opens when you walk to it. Can't really tell what's
the 20-sided core made him feel physically sick. Once he had sneaked into a temple of the dark art and he hadn't liked what he smelt and saw there, this felt like that. As quick as he could, he wrangled the icosahedron into the armature. The wheels began to spin, then glow. The sick feeling quickly spun away. Now he only felt sad. He had lost good friends for this war apparatus. He carried his prize back to the Farfarer. Now he had to make his next move. There was a key Imperial outpost on the Nexus. If this really was some sort of super weapon, he could use it to wreak havoc on the enemy. And if it wasn't, well, better to know that before the final battle. But maybe he should show it to some scientists first. There was an observatory on the Nexus. Maybe he should go there before he fired it. Of course, if you've just assembled a weapon out of legend that can exile gods from the world, you'd want to have a scientist or two look at it. And even if they disagreed and he had time, he could ask Calaveras himself. Yes, the observatory would be his objective.
Thanks for letting me choose it.
Why had the parts of the Sky Ripper only surfaced now, thousands of years after the Transcendent Emperor had dismantled it? The mad Emperor Isengrim had performed terrible, bloodthirsty rituals to invoke the lost gods. Was that why these ancient artifacts were rising out of the ground? How perfect, then, that the Sky Ripper would reappear to be his destruction.
Smash!
Follow me.
there was an inscription. Praise the sun. Nice. That could be useful. Guess now I find out what's next, he thought.
That's probably a good place to leave this one. Maybe next time we'll be able to do it on dying 100 times. We'll see y'all next time. Subscribe.